Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for joining the webinar. So my name is Sei Guan, and I'm based out of Singapore. So without further ado, let me get my presentation started. The topic for today is I'm going to introduce Rancher 2.6, which is a platform for enterprise-grade Kubernetes. So just the agenda for today. First, I'll start off with talking about a bit about SUSE and a bit about the history of SUSE as well as some of the products that we have. Next, I'm going to talk about Rancher. So to give everybody a better understanding on the background of Rancher, and again, the products that we have, and yeah, how Rancher is going to fit into the whole Kubernetes story. Before finally, I'm going to talk about some of the new features for Rancher 2.6. So Rancher 2.6 is the latest iteration of Rancher server, and we just released it probably 2 months ago. So it comes with quite a fair bit of new features, and I think it would be interesting enough to really share with all of you. Okay, so let me continue. Okay, first I'll talk about SUSE overview first. Just a timeline on how far SUSE has come, right? So we started in 1992. So there's a few milestones along the way, and in 2017 to present, that is where things are getting to be more exciting. So in 2019, we go into a partnership with EQT, and then in 2020, SUSE acquired Rancher Lab, which is now why we have the Rancher portfolio to talk about. And then in 2021, which is May this year, we are listed again in Frankfurt Stock Exchange. So now we are an independent company, and we are the largest independent open source company in the world right now. So, but despite, you know, going through all the changes, right, we are still 100% open source and community driven. So be it SUSE or Rancher or SUSE Rancher, the same core values still remain in all of us. So we wanted to give customer the best open source solution, the most flexibility that any customer would like to have. So just some of the customers that we have across all the industry. So pretty much every single big verticals and big companies that, you know, that I think you'll find a lot of names that are familiar to you. So just a slide on the Rancher snapshot. So this is not totally updated. So I pulled this out from the beginning of the year. We don't have an updated slide, but I think the numbers have changed significantly from then. But based on what we have in the earlier stage of the year, we have more than 100 million downloads. We have 35,000 active deployments and more than 400 enterprise customers. So again, you know, we have a broad industry adoption when it comes to Rancher and a lot of partnerships as well. So when it comes to Kubernetes, right, we are the leader in Kubernetes management. So according to Forrester, we are at the leading quadrant together with Red Hat, IBM, and Google. So this shows how much, you know, Forrester value us and how much we are able to bring to customer who wanted to embark on the journey with Rancher. So probably this is a more busy slide, and I will spend more time talking on this slide. So for those people who are familiar with SUSE, right, I think you will see that the product portfolio has changed quite significantly over the past few years. So originally, our products are not as streamlined as this. So you will see a graph with more than just three layers. So what we have did is we have made a lot of changes, and these are actually some tough decision, right? So we get rid of, or rather to put in a nicer way, right? We EOL some of the products that we think might not be so relevant to the current IT trending. So for example, we used to have something called SUSE Enterprise Storage that's based on Ceph. We also have OpenStack, SUSE OpenStack Cloud, and all these products are no longer around. So in fact, we also have a container as a service platform called CAS, as well as a cloud application platform based on Cloud Foundry. So all these are no longer around as well. So what we did is we did a streamline on our whole product portfolio. So let me go through this with you. At the bottom, this is just the hardware infrastructure, right? So you can see development environment or from data center to the cloud to the edge or any branches. So these are all the environment with all the hardware devices. We don't play in this area, but rather, we play on the layer that's above it. So first and foremost, we have our Linux layer. So again, we start off as a Linux company. We are the first company in the world to bring enterprise Linux solution to enterprises, to customers. So Linux is always has always been our blood, bread and butter. So again, we strive to bring good OS solution, enterprise-grade solution to all of you. So the Linux layer is still around. We have various variants. We have obviously the SLE server, we call it SLES. This is our main product. And from this SLES product, we have the SLES for SAP application. So this is our best-selling product out there, right? So over 70% of all SAP application that's deployed on top of Linux uses SUSE. So we are the industry leader when it comes to SLES for SAP, but we have other variants as well. So we have SLES that is tailor-made for HPC. We have SLES that is tailor-made for desktop, POS and other stuff. We also have something called SLE Micro. So this has just been released this year, SLE Micro. So the purpose of SLE Micro is to tap into two key area. First, it is to tap into the edge devices, and second, it is to integrate into containers. So right now, SLE Micro, we just launched the latest iteration of SLE Micro, SLE Micro 5.1, with quite a number of features that is supposed to work well with our eventual products. So on top of that, we have some extensions such as HA, high availability extension, or live patching extension that is supposed to be running on top of the SLE server. So it gives customer lesser downtime. So we would like to say that if you have both HA extension and live patching extension together on your system, you are able to achieve 99.999% uptime. So this is something that we always like to say. And on top of that, we have something called SUSE Manager. So the nice thing about SUSE Manager is, as you can see from here, right, you see the box here, other Linux. So SUSE Manager is a lifecycle management tool to manage not just SLES OS. It can also manage other Linux distros such as Red Hat, Ubuntu, Debian, and other OS. And we provide support for all these the OS clients, be it Red Hat or Ubuntu, that's being managed by SUSE Manager. So this is something that is I would think one of a kind. So in the market out there, I don't think there's another supported solution that's able to do that. But over at SUSE Manager is able to do that for you. So you don't need to have multiple lifecycle management tool in your environment. Just one SUSE Manager will do is able to provide lifecycle management capability to various Linux distro that you have in your environment, and then we provide support for you. So on the next layer, this is the key layer that we are going to talk about, is the Kubernetes layer. So this is all this solution comes from after we acquire Rancher. So these are the legacy products from Rancher. And over the course of a year, right, we are doing a lot of fine-tuning, we are doing a lot of improvement to the product line. So okay, I'm not going to dwell on this because I'm going to talk more on this later. So again, just want to reiterate SUSE's open and interoperable approach, right? So this is to map into the previous slide that I've shown you. So at the bottom, hybrid cloud infrastructure. So the next layer is the Linux layer. So the green color, the SLES product, and other Linux distro that we can manage using SUSE Manager. But the most important thing is, if you intend to run Kubernetes, or you intend to run Kubernetes that's being managed by Rancher. So the key thing is, Rancher don't just run on top of SLES OS. It is able to be run on top of any other Linux distro. And we will still provide support for the SUSE Rancher that's running on top of the other Linux distro. So the key thing is, if you already have a lot of your environment already have a lot of other Linux distro such as Red Hat, and you intend to make use of your current distro and then run Rancher or run Kubernetes on top of it, you can still do that with SUSE. So the key thing is, the key thing that I want to summarize over here is, we don't like to bind customer down to a stack. So customer is free to choose whatever they want to. So yeah, we don't like to practice things like vendor lock-in. So later on, I'm going to share more and it will become even more apparent. So with this, I come to the end of my SUSE overview. So I'm going to move on to venture overview. So as you can see from here, right, these are some of the projects and products that we have. The key differences between projects and products is for projects, right? It's based on open source projects. So first and foremost, SUSE and Rancher, both SUSE Rancher and all our products are based on open source projects. So what we do is based on these open source projects, we choose the best project that we think is can be aligned with the customer needs. And then we do a whole host of things like we do testing, we do certification, we do curating, we choose the best packages, and then we put it into a product. We productize it, then we sell subscription and give customer and provide customer with enterprise support. So this is what we normally do. So as you can see from here, we like to separate our initiative into products whereby it's commercially supported. We provide support as long as you have a subscription and projects. So again, products are based on projects that we have. So when the projects are mature enough, when the projects are good enough, we will productize it. So as you can see from here, some of the products in the Rancher 9 is this year. So first and foremost, we have Rancher. So it's a bit confusing because Rancher is the name of the company that we have bought over. So normally we would like to differentiate between Rancher and the product itself and the company. We would like to call this Rancher Server. So first and foremost, we have Rancher Server, which I will talk about extensively later on. We also have something called RKE and K3S. So no, Rancher is supposed to manage Kubernetes distribution. So as long as the Kubernetes distribution is CNCF certified, Rancher is able to manage it. So we also have our own version of Kubernetes distribution. So basically, a Kubernetes distribution is just some packages that we get from the upstream Kubernetes. We do packaging on it. We make it easier for customer to install, to manage, and to do lifecycle management and do upgrading and stuff on top of it. So the vanilla Kubernetes is very difficult to install and manage. So what we do is we have our own distribution. First and foremost, we have RKE. So RKE is a distribution that is more similar to a typical Kubernetes distribution. So normally, in order to have a production grade RKE cluster, right, you need to have three master node and two worker node. That's the basic. So it is very similar to whatever that you see for any Kubernetes distribution out there, right? So the other Kubernetes distribution that we have is something called K3S. So K3S is significantly different from RKE. So as I mentioned earlier on, right, RKE is able to make installation so much easier for Kubernetes. But K3S is going one step further, is going to make the consumption of Kubernetes even easier than RKE. So what we do is a K3S is a very, very lightweight Kubernetes distribution. It is very easy to install. So all in, the binary is less than 100 MB. So it's very suitable for edge devices whereby things like connectivity is limited. So when connectivity is limited, it's usually very hard to install because nowadays a lot of installation requires to have an active internet connection and then you pull everything down from the internet. So what we do is if you have a small binary, it's easy to just bring that particular binary and put into your edge devices where connectivity is limited and then install from there. So firstly is this, and secondly, because of the small footprint, it's not usually using a lot of resources. So again, when it comes to edge devices, right, we know that it comes in all shapes and size, but in general, the key thing is resources on edge devices are generally limited. And normally it could be just one single machine residing in a particular location. So as I mentioned earlier on for RKE, normally you need to have multiple nodes in order to run the production grade Kubernetes based on RKE. But for K3S, we understand the limitation for edge devices. So K3S can be deployed on just a single node. So this is the key feature of K3S. But in the event that you want to have high availability, you are able to link up multiple nodes as well and run K3S on top of it. So it's flexible, it's up to you. But the key thing is it allows customer to install production grade Kubernetes distribution on just one single node in the edge location. So this is the value of K3S. On top of that, we have something called Longhorn. So Longhorn provide persistent block storage for Kubernetes. So some of you might be wondering, why is there a need for, you know, persistent storage when we talk about containers? So container is supposed to be stateless, it's supposed to be immutable. So every time you run it, it's a brand new instances based on the image. And rightfully, every new deployment should be a brand new one. So why do you still need persistent storage? So this is to a certain extent is the older way of you know, thinking about how containers should work. So the newer way is more of, you know, a lot of containers nowadays is getting more and more, or rather I would say more and more people are making use of containers to deploy containers on production grade environment. So when we talk about production grade, there will be a lot of instances whereby stateful applications such as databases are required. And on Kubernetes itself, right, if you have you know, something like Longhorn, you're able to deploy stateful application on top of the cluster as well. So as SUSE, we provide something called Longhorn, which is a very easy way for you to consume, you know, persistent storage. When we talk about, let me go back a little bit more, right? When we talk about persistent storage on Kubernetes, if we use the older storage devices, it is not utilized and it's not optimized for Kubernetes. So there are a lot of restrictions and there's a lot of limitation as well. So for example, whenever one of the pods go down, in order to do a replication, it's going to take a long time using traditional storage devices. But if you have Longhorn, so it creates an additional layer over there for the pod to talk to the underlying backend, storage backend. So everything is being managed by Kubernetes. So it's so much easier and so much more efficient to have something like Longhorn deployed in your environment. So next, we have something called Hosted Rancher Service. So this is practically something like our, you know, software as a service. So for customer who do not want to deploy and manage Rancher server on their own, so we do provide a hosted Rancher service for you. So all you need to do is to, you know, subscribe to our subscription, and then we will, you know, do all the management of the Rancher server on behalf of you. So this is the Rancher service, the hosted Rancher service. And next, we have something called Rancher Fleet. So Fleet is making use of something, a new form of CI/CD. So a new form of continuous deployment method called GitOps. So it is making use of Git as the single source of truth. So from Git, right, you're able to, you know, just you know, make the changes from Git itself. And then if you have everything linked up properly, you have some deployment script that is based on Yammer, that's based on customize, or or even Helm, that is linked to that particular Git source code. Everything is linked up properly. You can link them up to Rancher Fleet, and then automate the deployment. So what you do is you make changes to the source code. The deployment code will take note of that. It will be synced to Rancher Fleet, and then Rancher Fleet would deploy all this. All the changes of the source code as the form of a container into whichever clusters that you intend to deploy these containers on. So this is Rancher Fleet. And based on our testing, it is able to be deployed up to millions of clusters at the network edge. So these are our products. And we do have some other projects that's ongoing as well. So Rancher Test is basically, you know, if you want to run Kubernetes or Rancher without a full deployment, you can just make use of Rancher desktop and you can run Kubernetes right on your desktop itself. So it makes things so much easier for you. So we have another initiative called Heaper. So Heaper is a dependency aware package manager built on Helm. So Helm is a package manager for application. So application on itself, if you want to deploy application, if you intend to deploy just a single pod or a deployment, these are the terms of Kubernetes, it is easy to do that. But if you intend to deploy a full-fledged application, whereby it is more than a deployment, it comes with services, it comes with secrets, it comes with config mess, all sorts of stuff, then you need to have a packaging method to package the whole thing together. So Helm is normally the industry standard to do that. So Helm is able to take together all the YAML files, all the deployments that's based on the particular application, and then deploy them together as a whole onto whichever Kubernetes cluster that you want to deploy to. So this is how Helm work. But then Helm itself doesn't come with, it is not dependency aware. So on certain occasion when you try to deploy an application, you try to use Helm to deploy it, you'll find that there will be some error message saying that they cannot find this, they cannot find that. So they're unable to do dependency checking on their own. So what Heaper can do is able to do that. We also have something called Harvester. So in fact, Harvester is going to be on tech preview soon. So on the latest Rancher version 2.61, we already have Harvester inside there. So Harvester is basically a hyper-converged infrastructure that is built on top of Kubernetes, Longhorn, and another open source project called KubeVirt. So basically, with Harvester, you're able to launch virtual machine on top of your Kubernetes cluster. So this is something new. Normally, we are talking about virtual machine and then running containers on top of virtual machine. So this is flipping the story around. Now you have a Kubernetes cluster, you're able to run virtual machine on top of the cluster. So next. So this is the whole Rancher ecosystem, right? Again, we like to put it down into layers so that everybody is easier to see. So at the bottom is the OS layer that I talked about earlier on. So on top of the OS layer, right? This is the Kubernetes layer. So just now I talked about, for Kubernetes, there's various kind of distribution. So distribution is basically there to make things easy for you to consume Kubernetes. So at the data center, SUSE Rancher, we ourselves, we have RKE as I talked about earlier on. At the edge, we have K3S. So on the cloud, on the public cloud, on the hyperscaler, so each on every of the hyperscaler, they have their own version of Kubernetes. So we like to call this hosted Kubernetes. So you have Amazon EKS, Azure AKS, and Google GKE among the other public cloud provider. So whatever it is, as long as it is CNCF certified. So if you intend to deploy Kubernetes in your data center, as long as it is CNCF certified, right? It does not necessarily need to be RKE. So any CNCF certified Kubernetes distribution, Rancher is able to manage them. And we are able to provide support for them as well. Right. So the key thing about Rancher is, when Rancher, okay, let me go back a little bit. So when we talk about Kubernetes, right? Kubernetes is a platform that is very useful when it comes to managing of containers. So originally, when containers has been around for a long time, but you only really take off probably a few years ago. So when people start to realize the value of containers, and it's so easy for developer or for end user to just launch a container and then consume application out of the container. But it reaches a point whereby it's so easy to develop application on top of container. It's so easy to consume container until a point you have so many containers to manage. So this is where Kubernetes come in. It provides a platform to manage all the container. So in the early days, right, we like to call Kubernetes belonging to a class of software called Kubernetes Management Platform. Oh, sorry, Containers Management Platform. So Kubernetes is there to help end user manage containers. So anything about containers, right, Kubernetes can do that very well. But it reaches a stage whereby there are two key new development. So firstly, Kubernetes in itself, it does not provide a lot of other lifecycle management tool or management of the underlying nodes running on top of the Kubernetes. So in itself, Kubernetes become limited and you need to have a better platform to manage Kubernetes. So this is more of the first development. And the second development is people tend to have more and more Kubernetes cluster going forward. So originally, as I mentioned, containers become so proliferating that you need to have something to manage containers. Now, the same thing is going to be applicable to Kubernetes. So Kubernetes has become so popular and it's so easy to consume Kubernetes that people, enterprises nowadays, they have so many Kubernetes clusters to manage. So especially when you talk about edge devices, right? Every edge device that you have can be considered to be one single Kubernetes cluster. So imagine you have probably 1,000 edge devices, that's 1,000 Kubernetes clusters for you to manage. So because of these two new development, you need to have a better way to manage Kubernetes. So Rancher is here to do that for you. So Rancher adds on to what Kubernetes can do. It provides things such as Kubernetes version management, GitOps continuous delivery, cluster template config enforcement, these are some, you know, some summarizing of some of things that we can do, right? But the key thing is we are able to do note pool management. So we are able to manage the underlying notes. We are able to do lifecycle management, you know, upgrading of the Kubernetes version and things like this as well. So these are some of the traditional pain points that Kubernetes users faces. So on top of that, we strive to make SUSE Venture, you know, a complete infrastructure solution for Kubernetes. So we have you know, policy, we have a central policy enforcement and governance tools that's being built into Kubernetes. So things like CIS benchmarking, RBAC control, and monitoring and logging and things like this. So on top of that, we try to make it easy for customer to consume applications as well. So as I mentioned earlier on, you know, applications that are harder to deploy, you know, it's not just a single deployment or single pod or single container. So those kind of application, we have our service catalog for, you know, for you to deploy all these application easily. And this service catalog is not just unique to those you know, those Rancher applications, that those applications that Rancher, you know, provide support for or provide integration for. You can add any, you know, any applications or any Helm charts that you want from any Git repo or from the Helm repo, and then integrate it into Rancher itself, and then have Rancher, you know, provide the application for you to launch. I mean, or for Rancher to provide the platform for you to launch any applications that you intend to deploy on top of your Kubernetes cluster. So this is what Rancher can do, and it can do something more than this. It is able to manage multiple cluster in one go. So we like to call Rancher a multi-cluster management console. So from a single console, you can manage all your Kubernetes cluster, be it in data center, be it in the cloud, or be it in the edge. So everything from one single single console. So just now I talked about, you know, applications, right? So at Rancher, again, we like to give customers the choice to choose whatever applications that they intend to deploy. So by making use of, you know, the some of the Helm charts that come out of the box, right, you are able to deploy some of the applications. But again, you are free to add more Helm charts to SUSE Rancher and then deploy any applications that you might want to deploy, or even applications that you develop on your own. But the key thing is, for those applications that come out of the box, we have two different kinds of SLA. So first, we have those applications that we provide full Rancher SLA on. So as you can see, some tools like Grafana, Prometheus, all these are very popular tools in the open source world. So this kind of tools, we provide complete SLA for these tools. And then for some of the other tools, we provide certified integration. So meaning that for the tools listed here, and by no means these tools, the list here is exhaustive. So there are certain tools that are not listed here. But anyway, for the tools that is in this category, we will provide support for the integration aspect of it. So for the event that if you deploy, for example, if you deploy Jenkins on top of any clusters that is being managed by Rancher, and you encounter any issue with the deployment, feel free to log a support ticket with us, and we will get to the root of the problem if it is really integration related. So the key thing here is we don't like to, you know, tie customer down to just a stack of components. We like to let customer choose whichever component that they think is the most useful to them. So just want to again highlight some of the things that I mentioned earlier on. So when we talk about flavors of Kubernetes, right? Normally we can broadly categorize into three. So this is the vanilla one, which I mentioned many times, is very difficult to consume, it's difficult to install, it's difficult to do lifecycle management. So we have the open source version. So this is the open source Kubernetes distribution that package everything together and make you easy to consume. But for this category, there's no support attached to it. So when you encounter any issue, you might need to find a fix yourself, be it doing troubleshooting or be going to the forum to look for fixes. So the third kind is the commercial kind. So again, a lot of companies, they package Kubernetes and then they provide support for it. So the key thing that I want to highlight here is Rancher is the only one that is in these two categories. So meaning that Rancher that you use for open source and Rancher that you use for commercial purposes is the same version. So in the event that you want to try out Rancher, you download Rancher, open source and test it. And after a while, you think that Rancher is something that you think is going to be useful for you. All you need to do is to buy a subscription and then it will turn into the commercial Rancher already. So for a lot of the other distribution out there, whenever you encounter this kind of things, you might need to do some migration or you need to do some lift and shift, which can be difficult and complex, or it's going to, at the minimum, cost you some downtime. So what Rancher does is we don't do that, and we let you test out and try out the full functionality of Rancher free of charge. So just want to show you the high-level architecture of Rancher. I'm not going to go into details here, but the key thing to take note is from one Rancher server, you're able to manage multiple clusters, Kubernetes clusters. So we like to call the clusters that Rancher manage the downstream clusters. So you can see from here, it can be, you know, based on the public cloud, or it can be just deployed on data center based on RKE. So one Rancher server is able to manage multiple downstream cluster. So just to summarize, SUSE Rancher's approach when it comes to Kubernetes and the direction that we want Rancher to move forward to. So first and foremost, as I explained earlier on, it's going to be a multi-cluster world. So going forward, everybody is going to have more and more Kubernetes cluster to manage. So definitely a good tool, a central console to manage all the clusters is going to be very important, and it's going to be something that every enterprise is going to look at in the future. So we also like to treat all Kubernetes distribution as first-class citizen. So again, we strive to provide full lifecycle support for all the clusters that's being managed by Rancher. So I'm going to talk a little bit more about that later on, because Rancher 2.6 come with a new feature which enhance this. So now the value is in the management of Kubernetes rather than the management of containers. And again, I would like to reiterate that we like to use the open approach to open source. So we want to give customers the freedom of choice. So with this, I'm going to talk about the new features of Rancher 2.6. So this slide summarizes the key, the three new category of features that's being built into Rancher 2.6. So first and foremost, we redesign the SUSE Rancher user experience. Next, we provide full lifecycle management for hosted Kubernetes clusters on AWS, Microsoft, and Google. So just now, as earlier on, when I say about, you know, we want to treat all Kubernetes clusters that's being managed by Rancher as first class citizen. So this is a giant step towards that. So again, you know, when we talk about Rancher, when we talk about Kubernetes, these are platform for you to deploy your enterprise grade application. So the key thing that we want to do is to continue to strengthen enterprise security and compliance on all the clusters that you are running on top of. So I'm going to go into each of these category next. So first, I'm going to talk about the redesign of SUSE Rancher user experience. So for those who have tried Rancher 2.5 before, if you try Rancher 2.6, you'll see that there's a lot of difference between the UI for Rancher 2.5 and Rancher 2.6. So it's basically a redesign of the whole Rancher UI. So when we talk about Rancher 2.5, right, you'll see that there seems to be two silo pieces over there. So there's one part of it that is called Cluster Explorer, and there's another piece that's called Cluster Manager. So it's a little bit for you to navigate that unless you are familiar with the system itself, right? And it's not intuitive enough. So some people find it difficult to toggle between these two. So at Rancher 2.6, we combine these two features together and make it easier for customer, for any users to consume Rancher. So from the Rancher UI, it is more intuitive and it's easier for you to go to whichever functions or whichever cluster that you intend to go to. So these are some of the new graphical features and capabilities. I'm not going to go through every single one of them, but I think the key thing here is, as I touched on earlier on, the new universal menu and navigation workflow. So this is something that is key to Rancher 2.6. And then there are some other features as well that's being built into Rancher 2.6. So I'm not going to go through every single one of every single one here. So just some screenshot to share with you on the Rancher web GUI. So everything is cleaner as compared to before. So we also have the monitoring and the alerting tools built into the Rancher UI itself. So previously, so in order to have this shown up, right, you need to install the monitoring and alerting tool into your Rancher server, into your clusters by making use of some of the applications that that come off the box with Rancher. So once you install this into your cluster, you are able to see all these matrices from Rancher itself. So you don't need to click on another button to go to check out the Grafana server or to check out the Prometheus server. If you want, you still can do that, but from the Rancher UI itself, just from a single glance, you're able to see all the matrices. So next, I'm going to talk a little bit more about the full lifecycle management for hosted Kubernetes cluster. So it was already introduced in version 2.5 for AWS EKS. So for AWS EKS, right, we provide full lifecycle management aspect on it. So basically, when we talk about full lifecycle management, you are able to, you know, deploy Kubernetes easily. You are able to do upgrading of Kubernetes easily, and you are able to manage the underlying nodes easily. So these are some of the key aspects when we talk about full lifecycle management. So in version 2.5, we already did that with AWS EKS, but it's not available for Azure AKS and Google GKE back then. So for Rancher 2.6, we integrate this feature into Azure AKS and Google GKE as well. And now for all the major hyperscaler, Google, Amazon, and Microsoft, we can now safely say that all this Kubernetes cluster that's being managed by Rancher, or rather that can be managed by Rancher, we are able to treat them as first-class citizen. So the key thing is, you know, if you make use of all this cluster just on the public cloud itself, it does not come with a lot of tooling. So as I mentioned earlier on, right, Rancher provide additional applications, additional tooling for any clusters that's being managed by Rancher. So because of this, if you intend to, if you have the intention to run all this tooling, you can use Rancher to manage them rather than, running them on their own. Because running them on their own is not easy to deploy all this tooling on top of them. So by integrating them into Rancher, it makes things so much easier for you. It is so much easier for you to deploy all this tooling into these clusters. So over here, you can see this table over here. It just show you the differences between using Rancher to manage all this cluster, all this hosted Kubernetes cluster, versus just running these clusters on your own. So the last category is to strengthen enterprise security and compliance. So first and foremost, secure images. So before we launch any Rancher images, we'll make sure that at the development pipeline, all these images that we are going to release in the future have been scanned and updated with the latest patches so that when it is released, there's no vulnerability, lapses, or and any security issues with that images. So feel free to consume them as and when you need it. Next, it is also, SUSE Rancher is also integrated with SUSE Linux Enterprise-based container image. So we like to call it BCI. So again, as I mentioned earlier on, right, you can deploy Rancher on top of any OS. But since Rancher and SUSE has already been, we already come together as one company, so we also give customer the choice to make use of the technology that comes integrated together. So now you are able to launch Rancher server with the BCI that comes with SUSE. So improve audit logs. So when for the previous version of Rancher, right, one of the key, I don't like to say it's an issue, but one of the key concerns the customer faces for the downstream cluster, they are unable to really see which user has logged into the cluster itself because the user is being tagged with the Rancher ID rather than the user ID. So we hear the feedback from customer. we made changes. So for Rancher 2.6, audit logs has been improved. So for the downstream clusters, rather than seeing Rancher ID, you are now able to see user ID. So it makes things so much easier for end user to keep track of their logging. So we also add KeyCloak to all the integration, all the authentication providers. So as I mentioned earlier on, right, SUSE Rancher, we allow customer to continue to use a lot of the tools that they are currently using, and then we provide support for all these tools. So initially, we already have a lot of Rancher server can already be used with a lot of these authentication providers, such as Active Directory, GitHub, even KeyCloak. That's based on the typical protocols such as SAML, LDAP, etc. So now we have an additional one, which is KeyCloak, that's based on a new protocol, OIDC. So again, this emphasizes that we like to integrate Rancher into more and more products to make things easier, to make it easier for customers to consume whichever products that they have with Rancher Server. So these are some of the tech preview for Rancher. So it comes with GitOps provision capabilities. So earlier on, I talked about Fit, right? So Fit is something that is able to link up Git, the Git repo, the source code together with whichever Kubernetes clusters that you intend to eventually deploy all these source codes into. So we move a step further. Now we are able to deploy RKE2 and K3S clusters using Fit. So this is somewhat a bit different to what I mentioned just now, but it's also making use of Fit capability. So this is an additional capability that's built on top of Fit. So I talked about K3S. What is K3S already? So RKE2 is something that is a new iteration, the new version of RKE. So that has it is built with compliance in mind. So it comes with things like FIPS compliance and higher security, higher and tougher security that's built into this particular Kubernetes distribution. So again, it is CNCF certified. So feel free to use this if you want to. But the key thing that I want to highlight here is for Rancher 2.6, now you are able to make use of the Rancher console itself to deploy RKE2 and K3S. To deploy Kubernetes clusters that's based on RKE2 and K3S. So another key thing is it's now making use of Cluster API to do the provisioning. So Cluster API is a new form of standard when we talk about managing of Kubernetes clusters. So originally, when Kubernetes cluster was first being when people first start to use Kubernetes, they did not think that Kubernetes is going to be so popular nowadays, whereby you need to manage Kubernetes, you need to manage multiple Kubernetes, you need to have a standard way to deploy and to upgrade Kubernetes and to manage the underlying nodes and stuff, right? So original way of the Kubernetes API doesn't take into account the cluster management aspect of it. So lately, there's a new initiative which is to come up with Cluster API based on, which is an extension of the Kubernetes KPI. So by making use of that, right, it is so much easier to deploy Kubernetes in a standard manner. So when we talk about the deploying of RKE2 and K3S cluster using Fit, right, it is also making use of Cluster API to talk to this cluster. And another key aspect is by doing that, it eliminates the use of SSH. So SSH tends to be the way we use when we deploy clusters from Rancher server. But then some people might not really want to enable SSH in their underlying nodes. So by using Cluster API, it can do away with SSH as well. So it also comes with additional container network providing options. So now we provide, so these are CNI, right? So out of the box, we already have quite a few CNI for Rancher 2.6, we already have quite a few Rancher CNI. So we already have Cardico, we already have Weave, we already have Canel and Fennel. So for Rancher 2.6, we add another CNI out of the box, so Cilium. And we have something called Mautus as well. So Mautus is an add-on on top of the CNI, which is able to provide port with more than one single network interface. So these are some of the new initiatives, and currently all these are in tech preview. So if you intend to try this out, feel free to download Rancher 2.6 and then give it a try. So with this, I come to the end of my presentation.